Hello everyone, I'm SL Coder. If you haven't watched my first video in this tutorial series, first go and watch it, because I'm not going to show you how to create your first project in this video. This video about start coding in Flutter and Dart. You can use any IDE. I'm using IntelliJ. If you want to use a VS Code, please go and watch my video about configure Flutter in VS Code. So let's get started. First of all, delete this code. Wait a minute. And read these comments. They have explained well. I'm gonna press Ctrl plus A and press delete key. Now to run a hello world app in Flutter, we only need 6 lines of code. A first line is import statement. This line is to add material designs to our UI. Material is a visual design standard on mobile and web. Let's type import. As you can see, IntelliSense show us what are the available packages to import. Let's type this inside open and close single quotes. Type package colon flutter forward slash material.dart. This line will import material.dart file from flutter directory. Now we can use widgets and material.dart file. And Flutter has rich set of widgets that we can use. What is a widget, by the way? Let me show you official website flutter.io/widget-intro. There is introduction section that says Flutter widgets are built using modern React style framework, which takes inspiration from React. In case if you do not know what is React is, React is a Java-ish framework from Facebook. Anyway, the central idea is that you build your UI out of widgets. Widgets describe what their view should look like given their current configuration and state. In Flutter, everything is widgets. Layouts, text, padding, alignment, the app is itself a widget. The second line is the main method. This method simply calls the runApp function or method. Add open and close curly bracket. Inside it, type runApp function. This runApp function is coming from the material.dart file. If you remove this import statement, you can see the function runApp is defined. Press Ctrl plus Z to undo. Now you can see another error message. One required argument expected but zero found. Simply means this function takes an argument and we haven't provided any. If you hold Ctrl and click on the runApp method, you can see the source code. RunApp takes an argument and that should be a widget. Let's go back to our code and let me add that argument. New is to instantiate an object or instance. Material app open and close bracket. This is the constructor for material app class. If we go to the source code by pressing Ctrl and click on this text, as you can see, it has so many properties. Let's use some of these properties now. Inside the open and close bracket, type name colon. This is a property and we can give values for properties. For now, let's add the text widget. New text is capital and inside the bracket and add single or double quotes and type anything. I'm gonna add hello world after close bracket, put a comma. Now it's not needed because we only specify one property, but this comma will help you to format your code. To format your code, right click and reformat with Dart empty. That will help you when you have a lot of widgets and properties. We have an error. Oh, there is no property called name in this material app constructor. It should be home. Sorry guys. So now let's run our app. Before that, let me show you one more thing. If you can't figure out how to configure AVD in IntelliJ, you can go to tools, Android device, AVD manager and create an AVD. For me, I prefer to use terminal, so I'm gonna use terminal to open emulator. In IntelliJ, you can find terminal in view, tool, windows, terminal, and to run emulator, we need to go to the directory, tools directory inside the Android SDK directory. This is boring because each and every time we do not want to copy and paste this path, right? There is a simple trick for that, and that is copy this path and go to system, advanced system settings, environmental variables, and add a new system variable. So I have added this, as you can see, I use the name as Android SDK. Now cool thing is when we use this variable, whenever we need to go to this tool directory, okay, press okay. I'm gonna close this window, and to use that variable, type cd space percentage variable name is Android SDK, and again press percentage mark and press enter. Now we are in the tools directory. Now to run emulator, type emulator space dash avd space avd name and press enter. In case if you have any problem, leave a comment. Otherwise you can watch my video about how to create avd. Now we can select the device and press run button. Here's our app. I know it's ugly. Okay, now let's go back to our code and let me show you another way that we can write this. Here, this fat arrow equal and angle bracket, close angle bracket, used to indicate that this is a one line function or a method. This is actually a shorthand to create a function in Dart. This way is good because we only have one property here. To add a title property, use title and colon space single quotes, and inside it type title that you want to add. I'm going to add hello world app. Now press hot reload button. Actually hot reload will not work here because we are changing the program elements inside the main method, passing straight to the main run app. Don't think about it too much for now. I will explain it in the next video. For now, just press run button to restart. As you can see, restart is also fast. Unfortunately, we cannot see this title. It's used by the device to identify the app for the user. By the way, home property is the root default root of the app. This is the root that is displayed first when the application is started. Root means the page, in this case home page. In Flutter they call it as roots. One last thing, here I couldn't show you the power of hot reload. I will also show you that in the next video. For now, let me just show you how we can center this hello world text. To do that, cut this and center widget, new space center, open and close bracket, add a property inside it called child colon, and then add the text widget. I'm going to paste it. Now the center is the root widget and text widget is the child widget of it. In another word, parent widget of text widget is the center widget. Widgets can have child widgets. Child widgets can have another child widgets. That child widget can have children widgets. Widgets. Don't panic. I will explain those clear in upcoming videos. For now, this is enough. Now let's press hot reload. Now we need to restart our app. Boom. Did you see that? Cool, right? Okay, everyone. I hope you learned something in this video. What do you think about this video? Please let me know. Subscribe button down below. If you wanna learn this tutorial series, you can press that button. Like this video if you like, and I'll see you in the next video.